memorize and register God's word. Galatians, the 5th chapter, the 13th and the 14th verse. I could have sang that song, Tim. Dang it. Chapter 36 verse. Matthew, Mark, Luke, who? John. John 8, 36. When you have it, say amen. I know the lights is dim. That's all right. Did it help y'all a little? Pause. John 8, 36. It says, so if the Son sets you free. Okay. I got two people that got excited. So if the Son set you, that's you and I, everybody in the building. If the Son sets you free, you will be what? Free indeed. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and an application of his holy and righteous word. Go ahead and take your seats. Today I want to talk about emancipation. Somebody say emancipation. Emancipation. If you don't understand, emancipation, it gives you freedom from the confines of what held you without reservation or strings. There are no ifs, ands, or buts about you and I being emancipated. Many of us know about the Emancipation Proclamation, right? How many of y'all know about the Emancipation Proclamation? If you don't, I'll talk to you after church. The Emancipation Proclamation, it was a document freeing those of African descent from the horrors of bondage. This particular document caused all in confinement to cease concerning their forced labor and their slavery. Well, you may ask, Pastor, how does this apply to us today? Somebody asks. I'm glad you asked. Many of us in the building are still shackled. Many of us in the building are still bound. Okay, well, many of us in the building are still confined. We're shackled, bound, and confined to mindsets, to thoughts. Okay, you know, how about this? People. And today, I boldly declare, I woke up, Reverend Jackie, just to come in the building today to tell everybody, I'm declaring your emancipation today. I'm declaring emancipation for everybody in this room, everybody in this building. If we can all be honest, our bondage comes from three areas in our lives. Now, one area that I say, it may not apply to you. Another one may not apply to you. And then for some of us, every area might apply. You might be bound up, hooked up, crooked up in every single area that I mentioned today. Three areas. There is a great need for emancipation today. A freeing of our minds and our hearts, never to return to our previous state. When slavery ended, how many of you know that some people had a tough time embracing their newfound freedom? Because they were so accustomed to hardships of bondage. What was wrong for them had become normal. Many of y'all are walking around right now in wrong, normal stuff. Amen. It had become normal for them. Now, the children of Israel, if you read the Bible, you understand when they were freed from slavery, they wanted to go back. They had freedom in the wilderness. They were being fed. Their clothes didn't wear out. But they still said, I want to go back. They wanted some cucumbers and beans. Let the church say amen. They wanted onions and hard treatment. They wanted to go back to creature comforts and things that were still part of their bondage. They want us to go back to things, to the evils that they had endured, the oppression that they had felt. If we all can be honest in the building, we do the exact same thing. We walk around in spiritual deficits because a call to more will require you and I to change. It will call us to have a newness in our walk. It will call us to have a newness in our activity. If you and I were really honest today, if we truly walk in the freedom that God provided, we could not continue on with what we've been continuing on with. Okay. Three things. Somebody say three things.
Three
that keep us bound. You ain't have to say that part. Amen. Somebody say thoughts that aren't of God.
Amen.
First thing, thoughts that aren't of God. Many of y'all walk around telling yourself that you ain't nothing and nobody. You walk around telling yourself that I'll never be more than what I am. You walk around telling yourself that I'm not going to do this and I'm not going to do that. As a matter of fact, many of you have owned the thoughts that other people have for you. You have taken what people have said to you all of your life. You have applied those things and you've painted a label across your chest about what somebody else think of you. All of us are victims of thoughts that are not of God. 2 Corinthians 10:5, Paul was telling the church at Corinth, it says, we demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God, and we take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. Listen, you and I, through the power of the Holy Spirit, we have the power to bring things under the blood of Jesus. Amen. We have the power to say, what they said about me means nothing for my life. We have the power to say, it does not matter what they called me. It does not matter what they did to me. None of those things will captivate and control my mind. We have the power to say, I am more than what people would ever say about me. I am what God says about me. What he says that I'm chosen. What he says that I'm redeemed. Those are the things that I need to think about. I'm not going to think about what my mama said to me anymore. I'm not going to think about what my dad said about me anymore. I'm not going to think about what my ex said about me anymore. Amen, somebody. You need to stop measuring yourself. You need to stop qualifying your thoughts with the things that people have said about you. All of us in the building have been victims of stinking thinking. Somebody say, stinking thinking. You've been thinking about stuff that you ain't even got to think about no more. You've been carrying stuff that you ain't even got to carry no more. You've been labeling yourself. You ain't got to label yourself no more. Yeah, you might have been what they said, but guess what? In God, you are a new creation. All things have passed away, and behold, all things are new. First thing, first problem you got is thoughts that aren't of God. Stinking thing. Then the second thing you got that keep you bound, people that mean you no good. Some of you say, no, Pastor, I got my thoughts under control. Well, you ain't got Pookie them under control. Let the church say amen. People that mean us no good. Somebody say, they mean me no good. Even though they make me laugh. Come on, stay with me. They mean me no good. Even though they didn't pay the bill. They mean me no good. Even though they took me out on a date. They mean me no good. Even though I put a label on them and called them my boo thing. Well, whatever y'all, you said people don't say that no more? Now you just told me, how you? Oh, baby. Oh, Lord, okay. Some of y'all, babe, don't need to stay. Amen. People that mean us no good. In Psalms 1:1-3 says, blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way that sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and when? Night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither, whatever they do, prospers. That gives you a picture of what your life looks like when you get around people who mean you well. If you are around a whole bunch of people, you got a whole crew and a whole clique, and your leaves are withering, you need to evaluate the circle that you got. Amen. You are still in bondage. You have not been emancipated if you surrounded yourself with people who mean you no good. Amen. If you surround yourself with people who always telling you and convincing you to turn up on somebody or just do a proverbial turn up, amen, you need to find you somebody else to be around, because they've got you in bondage. The scripture said that you are blessed when you don't hang around with people who mean you no good. The scripture said you will prosper when you don't hang around people who are pulling on you and using you and taking from you and never pouring anything positive into your life. Now that goes from 8 to 80. It don't matter your age. Amen, somebody. Some of y'all young people got the wrong people around you. You got the wrong friends. You got the wrong people. You think they cool, but they ain't cool. They gonna take you straight down a path that God don't want you on. Amen. People that mean us no good. Well, somebody say, well, now I got my thoughts in order. And somebody say, well, I got my crew in check. But a third thing is sin that easily ensnares us. Okay, I guess don't nobody need Jesus. Sin that easily ensnares us. So we got thoughts that are not of God. People that mean us no good. But sin that easily ensnares us. If you can't say amen at this point in the service, just say ouch. Because this applies to everybody in the room, from the pulpit all the way to the back pew. Amen. 1 Peter 2:16 says, live as free and not using your liberty for a cloak of maliciousness, but as the servants of God. Listen to this. Peter said that you and I, we've got to take the freedom that we have in God. The freedom that you have is not so you can just do what you want to do. I know you grown, but the freedom that you have in God is not just for you to do what you want to do. But the freedom that God has given you is so we can give him our lives, our worship, our praise, our adoration. Amen. The things that impact others here in the earth and will give us an impact as we leave this place. The Bible is telling us that sin should not be our master, and sin should not cover us. It should not keep us. It should not hinder us from the things that God has for us. You should not take your newfound freedom just to do what you want to do. Amen. Remember when you lived with your parents and your parents had rules? You thought the rules were stupid, and then you became grown and got your own house, and you got the same exact rules that your mom and your dad had. Them same rules that got on your nerves, them same rules that made you sick, the same rules that made you stump up the steps. Praise the Lord, I ain't got no steps because I break all those legs. Amen, somebody. My daddy was old when he had me, so I used to stump up the steps because he couldn't catch me. Amen. But I was young when I had Carlos, so you know he didn't see me. You and I have to understand that we've been emancipated. And you have to walk in that thing daily. You have to control what you think about and when you start thinking. How many know the Bible says, as a man thinks, so is he. That's one of the most powerful scriptures I've ever read in my life. I think I'm the mayor of Mason. Somebody go catch that. I think I'm the mayor of Mason. I be walking around like that. They be like, Your Honor, yes. Yep. Ain't nobody casting out man ballots. But if I don't believe in me, ain't nobody else gonna believe in me. But if I don't use the power that God has given me to change the trajectory of my life, I will be nowhere quick. I'll be nowhere fast. Understand today that you are emancipated. Stop wanting to go back into the things that God has delivered you from. When God has taken you out of something, he's taking you out for a better purpose and a better reason. Stop going back to the mud. Give yourself courage and he already cleaned you up. When God has broke a relationship for your ministry, some of them slaves was like, you know what? Somebody says something stupid, like, no, I'm emancipated. When somebody calls you what you used to be, you just shout out, what? When somebody calls you what you used to be, you just shout out. When somebody try to take you down a road that you used to go down, you just shout out. When somebody try to... designed for you to be.
Amen.
It's time for you to emancipate yourself out of the car.
Amen.
It's time for you to say, just hold on, pull over. Let me get out.
Yes.
And I'll catch a Uber. Amen.
Amen.
Or a Lyft or whatever it is.
Amen.
That's what they got nowadays, right? Uber and Lyft. Praise the Lord. We need to understand that we are free in God.
Yes.
And we need to stop binding ourselves because of how we feel. You get lonely at night. Go curl up to your Bible.
Amen.
Amen. Y'all don't do Netflix and chill anymore. You do Netflix and thrill. The thrill is gone. Amen. Gone away. Paul was telling the church at Galatians. I'm almost done, y'all. I'm sorry. I'm almost done. Paul was telling the church at Galatians, he said, listen, please. God has called you out of sin. He's called you out of a reprobate mindset. He's called you out of a lifestyle not pleasing. And in him calling you out of that, he's calling you into his service.
Yes.
Because you should understand when he called you, his service is better than any of the service that you provided on your own in the world.
Yes.
God's service, look, when God saved, who saved you in the building? Sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, and fire baptized.
Yeah.
Okay, every hand can go up, so I guess we need to run the water today. But listen to this. Your life
yes. Is
for somebody else.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pastor, what do you mean? I'm not a preacher. You ain't got to be a preacher. But your life
yes. Is
for somebody else.
Sure.
You are the hands, the feet, and the mouth of Jesus here in the earth realm.
Yeah.
You need to show somebody else what God has done for you.
Yes.
You need to show somebody else how God has freed you
yes. From
what used to have you bound. Many of y'all are still crying over what somebody did to you 10 years ago. I don't know who that's for. You still crying over what somebody did to you 10 years ago. Guess what? They ain't thinking about you. You need to be emancipated from that mindset. You ain't got to cry no more. What they did is a part of your testimony. Not a part of who you are, it's your testimony. How God brought you over and brought you out. There's no shame. Somebody shame. Ooh, I don't know what 10 years is for, but somebody is shamed. You ain't got to be ashamed of the mistakes that you made. You're still here. You're free today. You're emancipated. You're no longer a slave to sin. You're no longer a slave to anybody's thought process. You're no longer a slave to what people have said about you. You're no longer a slave to a label. You are emancipated today. You are totally and completely free. All I need you to do as we get ready to end service is say, you know what, Pastor? I'm going to walk free. Just say, Pastor, I'm going to walk free. Was born at Calvary. I'm going to walk free. My freedom was born in the grave. I'm going to walk free. My freedom was born when my Savior was whooped for me. I'm going to walk free. My freedom was purchased when he rose on the third day with all power in his hands. I'm going to walk free. even when I don't feel like it. Let us all stand.